I am here in Ikeja, in Lagos, of course, and I got invited by a company named SOFTCOM, and they definitely don't have to ask me twice to come over and see what they got to offer. So yeah, I took a look around already here in that very new location that they just moved into like 1 or 2 months ago. And it's beautiful, absolutely astonishing. You have to see that. So they're also working on different technologies, different products, if they offer different services. We'll learn about that in just about a couple of seconds. Stay tuned. Thank you very much for being here. Let's go and check out this beautiful new location. I am ready. Who is ready?
Okay.
How are you doing?
I'm doing fine.
Yes.
How are you?
I'm very fine. I'm very happy to be here today.
How long have you been in Nigeria now?
8 months.
8 months.
Yes. Oh, still very fresh. But yeah, I like Lagos. I would be very happy if you just introduce yourself again for the audience, of course, who you are and what you do.
Yeah. Okay. My name is Remy. For SOFTCOM, I focus on business intelligence.
Okay.
What I do is look within the business, look at the goals that we're trying to achieve, and try to see if the numbers that we're attaining is matching the results that we're gaining to us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, what I've seen so far here from the location, new office, it's wonderful. Like, it's you know, I could stay here all day and work. It's like,
You're welcome.
You don't have to offer me a job, I'll just stay here, I'll just work on my stuff. Beautiful location. Which topics are you working on?
At SOFTCOM, we focus on software, using software engineering to make people's lives better.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We want to do that by working with businesses and working with individuals.
Mm-hmm.
So it gives us that same, that balanced approach if we really want to improve the lives of people.
Yeah.
So if we're able to create more data and able to identify people, we can create better value for them. Healthcare, security.
Yes. Yes.
So that is something that we're also doing now. Yeah. And also finance.
Mm-hmm.
So we are playing now in the fintech space.
Yeah. Is there a special topic or a technology that you are focusing on when it comes to fintech, let's say?
The cost of getting people financial solution is high.
Yeah.
But what we decided to do, okay, let's use something that is a common value across many people, which is the mobile phone.
Mm.
So basically, we just turned your mobile phone number into your bank account.
Yeah.
We believe if people have access to the financial system, it can create more value for them, whereby they can be able to send money across, they can be able to have access to credit.
Absolutely.
You know, and once we have data about people, we can find more value to give them.
I mean, the fintech scene in Lagos is huge.
Actually, it is.
It's very big.
I wish I can find the reason why there's so much rush to it.
Yeah.
Because we are trying to reach more people are at the bottom of the pyramid.
Yeah.
And reaching them is not so much about the technology.
Yeah.
It's actually about the approach.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can have an amazing technology that no one can use.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you can have a very simple technology that people can adopt.
Mm-hmm.
So we have this platform whereby market women, farmers, you know, who have a mobile phone number and want to make financial transactions, can use our platform to make the financial transaction.
Yeah.
the all what is needed is the other party has to have a phone number. So, but most of these people don't have smartphones. So we've had to rely more on USSD. The communication to reach those people is also very key.
Everyone who is just like wondering why the lights went out, I mean, this is Nigeria. The very first interview that this is happening, so the audience might not know, but this happens quite often here on the mainland, right?
It's
an issue.
It's an issue. And so you realize that you can have an amazing technology, but many people still don't speak English. So we've had to have a support system that can be able to identify their languages and communicate to them effectively.
Got light again.
Got light,
Hello.
We actually want to be the next big thing out of Africa.
Next big thing, like, like what?
So in technology.
Yes,
we want to find a way for technology to improve lives. You know, we are, we have a large population first as a country and as a continent. We are constantly looking at different technological solutions that can reach people at scale and help them improve their lives.
Are you working already on the next big thing?
So I'll say EYOWO, which is the FinTech solution, is something that is still pretty new. So I'll say it's going to be the next big thing. Because we just launched last year and we're getting amazing traction. We plan to take this technology across Africa because the use case is very similar across board. Secondly is data. Our product is called Data Beaver. Data is something that we've not seen to manage well in this part. First of all, gather data. Analyze it well and make it usable for people who want to have access to certain benefits. And these people could be either governments, they could be businesses, or they could even be individuals.
It's more like a big data thing.
So I would say these two, which are pretty new, are going to be the next big thing for us.
All the best with that.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.
I hope to see the next big thing coming from SOFTCOM out of Africa.
Okay,
all right. Thank you very much.
Thank
it's been a pleasure.
Much.
Thanks for having me. Like this place. So, hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Let me place the cam here. Okay, got
it. So do your friends call you Mark or is it Marcus?
Well, there is actually no short form for Marcus.
Are you serious?
Yes. So I know that's different here in Nigeria, and I prefer the short names of Nigerian because most of the time it's
one
difficult name.
Yeah.
But okay, so
Marcus is simple.
Marcus is simple.